The fundamental theory in physics, which describes the physical properties of nature at the scale of atoms and subatomic particles, is known as quantum mechanics. It is the foundation of all quantum physics, including quantum chemistry, quantum field theory, quantum technology, and quantum information science.
I admit that there are things about quantum mechanics that are hard to wrap our minds around, but I don't think there's anything intrinsically unintelligible about it. So the message is that you can understand quantum mechanics, not that you can't. Of course, I am flying in the face of my esteemed predecessor at Caltech, Richard Feynman, who thinks I think I can safely say that nobody understands quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics is this wonderfully successful theory that we developed mostly over the first quarter of the 20th century that supposed to apply to everything in the universe, but really becomes manifest and necessary when we look at microscopic things, when we look at electrons or atoms or very, very small scale things. And we can use this theory to extraordinary precision. We can make predictions that have been tested to 12 decimal places of accuracy.
In contrast to classical physics, which describes many aspects of nature at a large or macroscopic scale, quantum mechanics explains the aspects of nature at a subatomic or microscopic level. It is interesting to note that most theories in classical physics can be derived from quantum mechanics as an approximation valid at a macroscopic scale. Another difference between the micro and macro world is that energy, momentum, angular momentum, and other quantities of a bound system in quantum mechanics are restricted to discrete sets of values or quantization. Objects that have characteristics of both particles and waves, a concept known as wave-particle duality. And there are limits to how accurately the value of a physical quantity can be predicted prior to its measurement, given a complete set of initial conditions. This is known as the uncertainty principle. In its most familiar form, this states that no preparation of a quantum particle can imply simultaneously precise predictions both for a measurement of its position and for a measurement of its momentum.
Quantum mechanics is absolutely necessary to understand why the sun shines or how transistors work. Even though we can use quantum mechanics to make predictions, if you ask physicists, but what's really happening, they don't know. And that's okay. It's okay not to know things, but when you don't know, what you should try to do is to learn, is to figure it out. And as a field, physics has decided not to do that. Rather than taking people who are trying to understand quantum mechanics at the deepest level and treat them as the superstars and most important people in the field, they push them out of the field. They've decided that trying to understand quantum mechanics at a deep level is not our job as physicists. It's only to make predictions. I think that this is bad. We used to try very hard to understand quantum mechanics and we subsequently stopped, and I think that was a mistake.
Quantum mechanics allows the calculation of properties and behavior of physical systems. It is typically applied to microscopic systems like molecules, atoms, and subatomic particles. It has been demonstrated to hold for complex molecules with thousands of atoms. But its application to human beings raises philosophical problems, such as Wigner's friend, which is a thought experiment first conceived by the physicist Eugene Wigner in 1961. The scenario involves an indirect observation of a quantum measurement. An observer observes another observer who performs a quantum measurement on a physical system. The two observers then formulate a statement about the physical system's state after the measurement according to the laws of quantum theory. However, in most of the interpretations of the quantum theory, the resulting statements of the two observers contradict each other. This reflects a seemingly incompatibility of two laws in quantum theory, the deterministic and the continuous time evolution of the state of a closed system and the non-deterministic discontinuous collapse of the state of a system upon measurement. Wigner's friend is therefore directly linked to the measurement problem in quantum mechanics with its famous Schrödinger's cat paradox. However, predictions of quantum mechanics have been verified experimentally to an extremely high degree of accuracy.
Don't think of the electron as a point particle in an orbit. Think of the electron as a wave. In particular, we dubbed this the wave function, which is the most boring, uninspiring name for the most important thing in all of physics. The wave function is the idea that rather than being in an orbit around the nucleus of the atom, think of the electron as being described by a wave that is spread out around the atom. The point is that there's a discrete set of different ways it can vibrate. Likewise, if you think of the electron as a wave rather than as a particle, there's a discrete set of shapes that wave can have in the atom. Erwin Schrödinger came up with an equation for how electron wave functions actually behave. So physicists love equations for good reasons. In words, the Schrödinger equation says, any one wave can be decomposed into different energy parts, and every energy part evolves at a separate rate. So the energy of the wave is proportional to how fast it evolves. That's the Schrödinger equation. That's the entire thing. So if you have a chunk of uranium, it's radioactive, it will actually emit electrons and alpha particles and things like that. And you can use the Schrödinger equation to say, well, what does the wave function of the emitted electron look like? The answer is, it looks like a spherical wave. The electron wave function comes out in all directions, more or less equally. There's details, but that's the basic story. But then you look at it, you never see an electron coming out in all directions equally. What you see are straight lines, trajectories, as if the electron is a particle again. What's up with that? We still have not answered this question, what's up with that? This is the sad part about the modern understanding of quantum mechanics. So what people said was, look, it looks like the way that electrons behave in their wave functions is different when you're not looking at them, like when they're in the nucleus, around the nucleus of an atom, versus when you are looking at them, like when they're in the bubble chamber or cloud chamber. Now, surely that can't be the final answer, but what the strategy adopted by physicists in the 1920s was is, yes, that's the final answer. So they invented an idea called the collapse of the wave function. They said, sure, wave functions for electrons or whatever, they obey the Schrödinger equation when you're not looking at them. But when you measure a quantum mechanical system, its wave function suddenly and unpredictably changes. And rather than predicting exactly what's going to be able to happen, you can predict the probability of different things happening. And the probability is largest where the wave function was largest. And after the measurement has occurred, the wave function changes to be localized where you observed it.
A fundamental feature of the theory is that it usually cannot predict with certainty what will happen, but only give probabilities. Mathematically, a probability is found by taking the square of the absolute value of a complex number, known as a probability amplitude. This is known as the Born rule, named after physicist Max Born. One consequence of the mathematical rules of quantum mechanics is a trade-off in predictability between different measurable quantities. The most famous form of this uncertainty principle says that no matter how a quantum particle is prepared or how carefully experiments upon it are arranged, it is impossible to have a precise prediction for a measurement of its position and also at the same time for a measurement of its momentum. Another spooky aspect in quantum mechanics is when quantum systems interact with each other and the result can be the creation of quantum entanglement. Their properties become so intertwined that a description of the whole solely in terms of the individual's parts is no longer possible. Contrary to popular belief, entanglement does not allow sending signals faster than light. Another possibility opened by entanglement is testing for hidden variables. Hypothetical properties more fundamental than the quantities addressed in quantum theory itself, knowledge of which would allow more exact predictions than quantum theory can provide. It is not possible to present these concepts in more than a superficial way without introducing the actual mathematics involved. Quantum mechanics has had an enormous success in explaining many of the features of our universe, with regards to small-scale and discrete quantities and interactions which cannot be explained by classical methods. Quantum mechanics is often the only theory that can reveal the individual's behavior of the subatomic particles that make up all forms of matter. It is perhaps the most successful theory ever formulated. For almost a century, experimenters have subjected it to rigorous tests, none of which called its foundations into question. It is truly one of the major triumphs in modern physics. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by liking, subscribing, and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.